Can you just give us a sense about the sort of stuff that is being tried out with regard to combination over the last week or so? And if you can give us an idea about whether you have frozen 11 or 12.
Yes, Callum, if you can mute others.
That's done, sorry.
Okay. Yeah, we have spoken about our combinations, obviously. I'm not going to reveal them right now, but we have put in place a very balanced team and something that we feel covers all bases properly. We are pretty confident in terms of execution as well, because you guys have been playing a lot of T20 cricket recently in the IPL, and everyone's playing well. So that is a very positive thing for the team. Now it's purely down to execution out there in the middle, which everyone, as I said, is confident to do so and professional enough to understand their roles. And role clarity is something that we have addressed already. So yeah, we feel we're very prepared.
Question, Sarkar? Shamik Chakravarti.
Hello, can I ask? Can I ask, Maureen?
Yes.
Hello.
Yeah, go ahead. I can hear you.
Virat, my question is that you surprised everyone with a decision to quit captaincy after the T20 World Cup. You gave a statement on Twitter also, but if you could just tell us, like, what prompted you, like, to take such a decision and announce it before the World Cup? If you could just give us a sense.
I've already explained myself a lot. I don't think I need to harp on that anymore. Our focus is to play well in this World Cup and do what we need to do as a team. And rest, I mean, people are trying to dig something that doesn't exist. And I'm not someone who's ever going to give fodder to that. And I've explained myself very honestly and openly. And if people feel that there's more to it or there's something that's not been told, I feel pretty bad for them, because that's certainly not the case.
Shamik Chakravarti, Rahul Rawat, and why don't you go?
Hi, Virat. Virat, as you have always maintained that for the team, it's just another game of cricket. But outside the hysteria it creates, sometimes does it get difficult to completely switch off from the atmosphere?
No, it does not. I mean, and it's a very situational thing, because we are in a situation where we are in charge of what we need to do on the field, and we understand for that to happen, we need to be in the most balanced space possible. We feel pressure playing any kind of game, and it's also a thing to understand that as professional cricketers, you eventually start thinking about the situation that you're going to be in as batsmen and bowlers, or batters and bowlers, so I should say. And it's very important for us to keep focused on that, because you know, a game like this, there's such unnecessary stuff from a professional point of view happening on the outside that it's fine. It's fine as long as that stays outside, you know, our controlled environment, and we just focus on what we need to do as cricketers. And hence, I always maintain that for me, it's never been different to any other game of cricket that we play. Yes, the atmosphere in the stadium is different, and our mindset is not different. Our preparations are not different, and our approach to the game is also certainly not different.
Hi Virat, Rohit in the last warm-up game, he said that hopefully Hardik Pandya would be good enough to bowl a few overs by the time the tournament starts. So just wanted to check if he's able to bowl now, and secondly, if he doesn't, does that go against him when it comes to selection, the playing 11? And B, how much would toss be a factor considering in the second half of the evening matches the dew comes into play?
Well, I honestly, I feel that Hardik presently, with his physical condition, is getting better in terms of being prepared to bowl at least 2 overs for us at a certain stage in this tournament. And we strongly feel that we can make the most of the opportunity that we have at hand till the time he starts bowling. We have considered a couple of other options to chip in for an over or two. So we are not bothered about that at all. What he brings at that number six spot is something that you just can't create overnight. And hence, I was always in favor of backing him in Australia as a batter purely. And we saw what he did in the T20 series and how he can take the game away from the opposition when he's in full flow. So these things, from a talking or a discussion point of view, seem very, very interesting that if he doesn't bowl, will he be left out? But we understand the value he brings to the team as a number six batter. And in world cricket, if you look around, there are specialists who do that job. And it's very important to have that guy, especially in T20 cricket, who can play an impact innings at that stage. Even when the chips are down, he's someone who can play a long innings playing in that way. So for us, that is way more valuable than forcing him to do something that he's not ready for at the moment. But he's motivated and he's very keen to start giving us a couple of overs. And when that happens, obviously the balance becomes even better. But we are pretty confident how we are heading into the start of this tournament.
Baidu, Joe, your turn.
Yeah. Hi, Virat. Firstly, best of luck for tomorrow's game. And, over the years, Virat, we've seen that whenever it's an India-Pakistan contest, it's generally the Pakistan bowlers versus the Indian batsmen. But this time round, obviously, the Indian team itself has some of the best bowlers in the business. So, I mean, as a captain, how confident are you going into the game when you have a bowling lineup like that?
We try and go into any game with absolute preparation, understanding of our plans, what we need to do against the opposition. And as long as we do that, we go in confident against any team in the world, anywhere. So now for me to say that now we have great bowlers and we didn't have great bowlers before. I mean, we have won in T20 World Cups every time we've played them. So if it was only a case of our bowling being weak, then we probably shouldn't have won those games. So I don't think on those lines. For me, what matters is how the individuals are playing at that particular time. And what I can say is that all the people in the team are playing their roles to perfection, are executing their plans really, really well. And that gives us a lot of confidence heading into this tournament.
We shall take two more questions from Indian media and move on to international media then. Gopal Krishnan Vishwanath and then Sunand and Lele, who wants to ask a question in Hindi.
Can you hear me, Maulin?
Yes.
Yeah, Virat, you have seen the 30-odd matches played in the IPL and with some trains available of the pitches at all three venues. You are going to play at much of a match in Dubai and one at Abu Dhabi. Do you think during the last 10 days, much work would have gone on the pitch and will there be a significant change in the quality of the pitches?
I believe so. I mean, looking at the IPL finals, I believe that the quality of pitches definitely is going to be far better in this T20 World Cup. Also, it being an ICC tournament, we know that the standard of pitches has to be maintained to a certain degree, which is consistent across all venues. And I understand that to protect the pitches for a tournament like the World Cup, there had to be some kind of compromise in terms of the playing conditions when we played the IPL. So we all understood that. And the wicket in the IPL finals was very, very good. And I think someone asked me about the dew factor as well and how the toss is going to be important. I think the dew factor is becoming prominent as we head into this time of the year in Dubai. And that is also going to help the pitchers play much better. I presume Abu Dhabi and Dubai are going to be probably the best pitches out of all the venues. And Sharjah more or less, will stay true to its true nature, which is slow and low. And I don't see many high scoring unless dew becomes such a massive factor there as well. But yeah, wickets, I feel, are going to be much better in this one.
Thanks, Vidal.
Maulin, main isi se pooch raha hu, Vishy ke isse.
जी जी सर
विराट टी20 क्रिकेट में क्लैरिटी ऑफ थॉट होना कितना जरूरी है, क्योंकि दो ओवर इधर उधर हो गए तो बहुत कुछ फर्क पड़ता है मैच के ऊपर, तो ये बैटिंग हो या बॉलिंग हो या आप कप्तानी कर रही है, क्लैरिटी ऑफ थॉट होना कितना जरूरी है?
बहुत क्रूशल हो जाता है सर, क्योंकि आप दो तीन ओवर के बारे में आपने बात की, मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि आज की क्रिकेट में तीन या चार बॉल में पूरे गेम का मोमेंटम चेंज हो जाता है टी20 क्रिकेट में, जिस तरीके से आप एज अ बैट्समैन बॉलर के प्लान्स को रिस्पॉन्ड करते हैं, या एज अ बॉलर जिस तरीके से आप पहले या दूसरे बॉल में बाउंड्री खाने के बाद अगले चार बॉल या पांच बॉल डालते हैं, आई थिंक वो चीजें बहुत एक इम्पॉर्टेंट पीरियड बन जाता है एक टी20 मैच में, और एक एक सेंस हो जाता है सब लोगों को मोमेंटम शिफ्ट हुआ है, तो इसीलिए मैंने बोला कि हम लोग जो टी20 क्रिकेट खेल के आए हैं अभी और जो हम लोगों ने सबने एग्जीक्यूशन करी है आईपीएल में, उससे काफी मदद मिलेगी हमको और कॉन्फिडेंटली अपने प्लान्स को एग्जीक्यूट करने के लिए, और उसमें प्रिसाइज रहना बहुत जरूरी है, क्योंकि जैसे मैंने बोला कि मोमेंटम बहुत जल्दी शिफ्ट होता है, और अपने आप को बैक करना बहुत जरूरी है विद क्लैरिटी और कन्विक्शन के साथ।
कैप्टन, वी विल टेक कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान मीडिया। अब्दुल गफर एंड एजाज वसीम बकरी।
हेलो विराज, थैंक यू। विराज, ऑब्वियसली पाकिस्तान के इस रिकॉर्ड के बारे में बहुत बात होती है कि हम कभी पाकिस्तान भारत से जीत नहीं सका, और एक नफसियाती दबाव रहता है भारतीय टीम या तो भारतीय कैप्टन, आप क्या ये चीज डिस्कस या ये चीज आप लोग के माइंड में होती है, रिलैक्स करती है, नया गेम होता है? दूसरा, पाकिस्तान के कप्तान बाबर आजम ने शायद पहली मरतबा किसी पाकिस्तानी कप्तान ने कहा कि बैटिंग हमारी स्ट्रेंथ है और हम अपनी बैटिंग पर बड़ा रिलाई करेंगे, सो आप भी पाकिस्तान की टीम के बारे में ऐसे ही सोचते हैं? थैंक यू।
नहीं, हम लोगों ने कभी इन चीजों को डिस्कस नहीं किया है कि क्या हमारा रिकॉर्ड रहा है और हमने क्या इन द पास्ट किया है। जैसे मैंने बोला कि इन चीजों से काफी डिस्ट्रैक्शंस क्रिएट होती हैं, और मैटर ये करता है कि आप कैसी प्रिपरेशन करते हैं और उस दिन आप किस तरीके की क्रिकेट खेलते हैं, रिगार्डलेस कि आपके सामने ऑपोजिशन कौन है। और हमने अच्छी क्रिकेट खेली उन सब मैचेस में, इसीलिए हम जीत पाए। मतलब अगर सिर्फ रिकॉर्ड के माहौल से अगर हम गेम को अप्रोच करते तो आई डोंट थिंक कि इस लेवल पे वो चीजें काम करती हैं, वो बल्कि उल्टा आपको आपके ऊपर और एडेड बैगेज या एडेड प्रेशर क्रिएट करती हैं। और दूसरी बात, पाकिस्तान टीम मेरे हिसाब से काफ़ी स्ट्रॉन्ग टीम है और हमेशा स्ट्रॉन्ग टीम रही है, और उनके अगेंस्ट आपको हमेशा अपनी बेस्ट क्रिकेट खेलनी पड़ती है, क्योंकि उनके पास बहुत टैलेंट है और ऐसे प्लेयर्स हैं जो गेम को चेंज कर सकते हैं कभी भी, और ऐसी टीमों के अगेंस्ट आपको अपना अपना बेस्ट प्लान लेके आना पड़ता है सामने, और मेक श्योर करना है कि एग्जीक्यूशन हमारी अच्छी हो और हम कंसिस्टेंटली जितना खेलेंगे उतना हम प्रेशर बना पाएंगे ऑपोजिशन पे, तो हमें डेफिनेटली अपनी गेम लेके आना पड़ेगा।
हाय विराट, मेरा सवाल ये था कि तकरीबन पिछले 2-2.5 साल से तमाम जो इंटरनेशनल टीमें हैं वो इस पेंडेमिक में खेल रही हैं। 2019 का वर्ल्ड कप बड़ा इजी था इंग्लैंड में, जब आप सब लोग खेले और टीमों ने अच्छा परफॉर्म किया, तो कितना टफ है एक बायोसिक्योर बबल से निकल के फिर इस वर्ल्ड कप में आ जाना, सिर्फ इंडियन टीम के लिए नहीं बाकी तमाम लोगों के लिए इफेक्ट होते हैं, प्लेयर्स प्रैक्टिस से निकले और होटल में बंद हो गए और कल जाके मैच खेलेंगे?
काफी काफी अच्छा सवाल पूछा है आपने, काफी बात हुई है इस चीज के बारे में। अच्छी बात यह है कि हम एक आईपीएल जैसा टूर्नामेंट खेले जिसमें 60 टीमें और होती हैं, आपके पास रोज हर हफ्ते नया चैलेंज होता है, तो आप इन्वॉल्व रहते हैं गेम में कि यू नो टूर्नामेंट एक बिल्डअप हो रहा है, 1.5 महीने का पीरियड होता है और आप जाके एक चीज की तरफ आप एक गोल को अचीव करना चाह रहे हैं, और अभी वर्ल्ड कप में भी उस तरीके की कि हमें एक मोटिवेशन मिलती है कि आप मल्टीनेशनल टूर्नामेंट खेल रहे हैं, अलग अलग टीमों के अगेंस्ट खेलने का मौका है जिनके अगेंस्ट आप पहले कभी शायद ना खेले हो और खेलने का मौका ना मिला हो, तो ये सब चीजों से नए चैलेंजेस उभर के आते हैं जिससे आप अपना फोकस रख पाते हैं। बट आई थिंक आगे जाते हुए इस चीज को कंसिडर करना बहुत जरूरी है कि मुझे समझ है कि काफी टाइम क्रिकेट नहीं हुआ है दुनिया में, बट उसको कवर अप करने के चक्कर में अगर आप प्लेयर खो बैठेंगे तो आई डोंट थिंक कि वर्ल्ड क्रिकेट को उससे कुछ फायदा होने वाला है, तो आई थिंक इसका बैलेंस बना के चलना आगे बहुत जरूरी है कि प्लेयरों से भी एक कम्युनिकेशन हो कि आप लोगों को क्या चाहिए, आप लोग कहाँ प्लेस हैं, बायो बबल्स में मेंटली कौन इंडिविजुअली किस स्टेज पे आप नहीं बता सकते हैं। आप अगर 5-6 लोगों को आप हंसते खेलते देख रहे हो तो आप ये नहीं डिटरमिन कर सकते हैं कि हाँ सारे 15-16 लोग जो है वो सारे एक जैसा ही फील कर रहे होंगे। सबकी अपनी अपनी सिचुएशन होती है, तो आई थिंक उसको बहुत जरूरी है अपने दिमाग में रखना कि आप कम्युनिकेशन रखिए प्लेयरों से और उनको पीरियोडिक पीरियड्स दें जहाँ पे वो मेंटली रिफ्रेश होकर फिर से ऐसे एनवायरनमेंट में आ सके जहाँ पे वो फिर से कम्पीट कर सके। तो आई थिंक ये बहुत जरूरी है।